Get ready for your daily dose of WordPress and web development tips, tricks, and insights to help you find success with WordPress. You're listening to WP the Podcast with your hosts, David Blackman and Tim Streifler.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of WP the Podcast, brought to you by WP Gears. I'm David Blackman.
And I'm Tim Streifler.
Today we're going to talk about the best plugins for rebranding the back end of WordPress. This is part two of our two-part series. Yesterday we discussed why it's important to potentially rebrand the back end of WordPress, and today we're going to give you the tools for doing that. Tim started us off yesterday, and guess what? I'm going to let him start off today.
Definitely. So the first tool that we recommend, it's on the top of the list. It's my favorite tool for rebranding the back end of WordPress, and it's from our friends over at WPMU Dev, and it is Ultimate Branding. I've been using Ultimate Branding for quite a few years now. I've been a customer of WPMU Devs, I think since either 2012 or 2013. Ultimate Branding, it's been there as long as I've been a customer, and they just recently rebranded Ultimate Branding. They redid the backend UI, and so it's and added some features and stuff like that. So Ultimate Branding is awesome. With a few clicks, you can totally rebrand the backend of WordPress. You can put your logo front and center, put it on the login screen. You can customize the login screen. There is just a plethora of different options and things that you can do. Change the email so that when someone resets their password, it doesn't say WordPress, it will say your company or your client's company, whatever it may be. So Ultimate Branding is awesome. It is a paid plugin as part of the WPMU Dev suite, but it is definitely well worth the money.
And the next couple that we won't dive into, we're just going to mention, are free options. Obviously, with WP the Podcast, we like to give you kind of the options that we like, which a lot of times tend to be paid options. However, We always like to give the free options as well. So two that you can check out on the repository are White Label CMS and Remove WP Branding. And both of these are free options in the repository with great reviews, lots of active installations, and that's important. They're pretty simple to use. They will rebrand the back end of WordPress, basically remove the WordPress branding. So check those out if you're looking for a free option.
Definitely. And David and I are both product creators in the Divi community. And so we have a lot of Divi products. And we actually both have a product that lets you do what we've been talking about, rebrand not just WordPress, but Divi specific things. So for example, I'll talk about David's and then he can talk about mine. That way we're not self-promoting exactly. But David and his company, they have an awesome product called Divi Ghoster, which basically it allows you to hide everything Divi, but instead put your name. So anytime it would say Divi, you can have it say David Blackman or Acme Agency, whatever your company is. And then also you can replace the Divi logo with the with your own logo. And so very, very powerful plugin. Highly recommend it if you're using the Divi theme. And that way, again, it's not that your clients will... not that they care that you're using Divi, but sometimes it can just be a distraction. And so you can really take advantage of the branding opportunity by showing your company instead of Divi.
And last but not least, we want to give you a free tutorial. If you don't want to use any plugins whatsoever and you want to customize the login page.
You didn't talk about my plugin.
Oh, darn. I thought you talked about both of them.
No, I said I'll talk about David's and then he can talk about mine.
Oh, darn. Sorry, Tim. I got a little bit distracted. I heard you Divi community and I saw our list and I thought you were covering both of them and I was okay with it. Okay.
No
Let
worries.
Me talk to you about Tim's awesome plugin in the Divi community, Divi Dashboard Welcome. This is a fantastic plugin that allows you to use the Divi Builder inside the back end of WordPress's dashboard. If you've ever used the Divi Builder, you realize the power and flexibility of this tool. It's incredible. This will allow you to, you know, brand the dashboard of your Divi website, which is huge. And if you've you know, pretty much whatever you can dream up, you can have. So if you want to put custom forms or, you know, allow people to email and sign up and do just a whole bunch of awesome stuff, Divi Dashboard Welcome is a fantastic tool that you can do that with. Did I do a good job, Tim?
That was awesome. Yeah, thank you.
Sorry about that.
No, I threw that. That wasn't part of our plan, but at the last second, I was like, oh, I'll talk about Ghoster and Dave can talk about Welcome. So we didn't talk about it.
My bad.
Yeah. You want to talk about the tutorial since I threw you for a loop?
Yeah, that's okay. We also wanted to give you a free tutorial. You know, plugins are great, but at the end of the day, you may not need plugins and all the functionality that they have. You may just want to simply customize the login page of WordPress. There's many, many tutorials out there. If you Google it, you're going to find a tutorial. One of our favorites is a free tutorial by our buddies over at WPMU Dev. We're going to put a link into the show notes and they're going to show you a step-by-step process on how to customize the WordPress login page. So check it out. Tomorrow we're going to talk about PNGs, JPEGs, and Tim, is it GIF or JIF?
I say it's GIF, and I'll explain why in tomorrow's episode.
I'm going with GIF myself. So which should you be using on your clients' websites? Tim, until tomorrow, we'll see you then.
Take care. Bye-bye.
We've come to the end of today's episode of WP the Podcast. Join us tomorrow for more daily tips and strategies designed to help you run your WordPress business towards success. Remember to subscribe to WP the Podcast so you can stay up to date with each episode. And don't forget to rate and review us. We'll see you again tomorrow, right here on WP the Podcast.